morning. On Tuesday evening at approximately 6:50 p.m., a U-28 aircraft assigned to Cannon Air Force Base crashed during a training sortie near Clovis Municipal Airport. The three crew members on board the aircraft perished in the crash. Local first responders and civic authorities reacted to the incident and put out a fire that was a result of the crash, and an investigation into the crash is currently in progress. Our focus right now is on taking care of our loved ones, friends, and our larger Air Commando family. Therefore, we will not release the names of those in the crash until 24 hours after next of kin notifications have been made. Our priority in the wing's training and operational mission here at Cannon Air Force Base is on safe mission accomplishment. The investigation is intended to find out what happened to preclude future reoccurrence. Our air crew and the aircraft they operate are well trained and well maintained. Last night, to fully react to this incident, we ceased local flying operations here at Cannon. Today, we've resumed flight operations with the temporary exception of the 318th Special Operations Squadron that operates the U-28. Before I take some of your questions, I'd like to first express our thanks and appreciation to local authorities and first responders that reacted to the incident, and also express our appreciation to our local communities, friends and partners that have expressed an outpouring of support for us as part of our larger community here on the High Plains. With that, I'd like to take some of your questions.
My name is Rachel Goldhart. I work for News Channel 10 in Amarillo. When is the last time something like this happened here at Cannon Air Force Base?
So we have not had an aircraft mishap involving fatalities here at Cannon Air Force Base for several years. The U-28 aircraft is a reliable, safely performing airplane that we fly thousands of hours on, and every year our air crews fly hundreds of hours to maintain their currency and proficiency. This is the first mishap in quite some time.
My name is Leonard. I'm with KOB Eyewitness News 4 out of Albuquerque. Are we able to know the ages and or genders of the airmen that were killed in this crash?
No, so at this time we're not going to release the details of the members involved. They were three active duty airmen assigned to Cannon Air Force Base. Again, the notification of those family members are in progress, and we'll release those names when that information can be done.
Thank you.
Shannon Wilson, KOAZ7 Albuquerque. What is this plane used for particularly?
So the Pilatus U-28 aircraft is an intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance platform. It's single-engined with a crew of 3 to 4 personnel that performs on-station reconnaissance missions, both for training here in the continental United States, and we deploy them overseas to contingency operations as well.
Kevin Wilson, East from Mexico News.
What was the nature of the training sortie, and what were the roles of the three involved?
Okay, so the training sortie was a local profile in which our air crews will take the aircraft for several hours, operate here in eastern New Mexico or West Texas, and that can involve anything from tactical scenarios to pilot proficiency training, which is in and around airports just to safely fly and conduct takeoff, landing, and en route operations with the aircraft. Go ahead.
When's the last time these three airmen have been in this scenario together, and how many hours as a team have they had training so far?
So again, the details of the crew complement and what their qualifications were at the time of the accident is still part of the safety investigation that's currently ongoing, so we won't talk about those right now. I will say that again, for the U-28 community in general, the pilots, co-pilots, combat systems operators in the aircraft fly several hundred hours a year to really hone their tactical proficiency in executing their mission. Again, it'd be premature to speculate on those details at this time. Obviously, with the safety investigation in progress, right now we're working to secure all the data from both the wreckage and the documentation that went into the preparation and conduct of that sortie, Once that safety investigation goes through to its normal outcome, then some of that information will be releasable. But I won't speculate on the cause at this time.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll have time for about three more questions. We'll start with you in the blue here.
Leonard from KOB again. How has this event affected the community of Buchanan Air Force Base? What are some of the emotions and response that you guys are getting from other crewmen and airmen here at the Air Force Base?
Yeah, so I appreciate that thought and comment, and also, again, the outpouring of support we've gotten from off-base to our community here on-base. We at Cannon Air Force Base are a tight-knit installation and wing focused on getting the mission done, and obviously any time an incident like this occurs, it hits us hard. Again, right now our focus is on those families to make sure they get the care team support from our chaplains, our health teams, providers, and most importantly, our family unto itself, to make sure that we respond to this incident and then can move forward from there.
Mandy in the black here.
Go ahead.
Is there any indication whatsoever in the moments leading up that something may have been wrong before, maybe there was a fire in a plane on the ground?
So right now we have no indications of a pre-existing condition prior to the crash occurring. So all that documentation has currently also been collected and is under review as part of the safety investigation. That goes into the comprehensive review of the incident, and again, to try to determine positively what happened and to make sure that it doesn't happen again in the future. Go ahead, fine.
The location near close municipal airport, was that coincidental or was that in any way related to the crash?
So Clovis Municipal Airport was part of the planned training profile, so that it was part of their routine sortie, and that was where the incident then occurred. Okay, at this time, I thank you for your questions this morning. Again, if I could leave you with a couple parting thoughts. Please, again, I appreciate the outpouring of support from our communities and first responders. Again, the crash site itself is still an investigative scene, so I'd appreciate that anyone interested and finding out more about the accident or expressing support for what occurred, please refer those queries to our base public affairs office and Captain Bacom so that we can, again, focus on taking care of our airmen and their families and then prioritize the safe mission accomplishment that this wing executes every day. Thank you again and good morning.